Hey, this is Mike. You're on jamplay.com. And now we're going to learn the song right here off of our record, Chapter 5. It was the first single off of that record. And what I remember about this song, this is one of those riffs I always record things that I do that I think are kind of catchy. And the main riff to this song is something that I went back, had no recollection of playing, and kind of built the song around that. Kind of changed it a little bit, but I mean, it was the main fast-picked part in the song. So why don't we dive into the song now? There's a little acoustic at the top, but why don't we learn that part first, and we'll learn the rest of it. So here we go. So that's the intro acoustic part that starts the top of the song. Starts off with in the second position, B chord. Open second and first string, so it's. So I'll play that part again, and then we move the index finger down to the F sharp on the second fret on the first string, so it's. Pull off. So it's. And that last one's a pull off. And you hit the same note again. Then it goes to an A. Again, with just the first and second string open. So it plays the open high strings. That off, pull off to there. So the two chords together sound like this. The next chord is a G chord. So open fourth string, open second and first. Pick it back down, open to. So that's 4-4-2, open, starting on the fourth string. To the A, to the B. So slowly, the whole progression put together should sound like this. That part gets repeated again at the top of the bridge and then goes into another acoustic part, which we will learn next. So basically, we're outlining the chords in the chorus on the acoustic part in a breakdown of the chorus that builds into the last chorus of the song. So, starts out with a D. To an F sharp. To a B, where you can let the high strings ring a little bit. To a G. Repeat. And this song, like all Stain songs on acoustic, is down a half step, so it's E flat to E flat. And that's it for the acoustic for this song. So that that's a lick that I first heard that kind of drew me to the song that I thought was kind of cool and kind of built the song around that. The tuning for this song is G sharp, D sharp, A sharp, C sharp, D sharp, and G sharp. So what I'm doing on the high strings is I'm tuning those down. And then from there, so it kind of gives you that little chord there. And that high note always pokes out in this riff, so. And allows you to get the harmonics properly that we'll teach later on. The first chord starts out like a fifth chord, starting on the seventh fret on the fifth string. And all the other strings are open, so it's, I'll pick it slowly. And that picking pattern stays the same all the way through. Fourth string, third string, fifth string, third string, second string, third string, fifth string. So it's... The only time the fourth string gets played is the first note of the picking pattern. So it's... Four times it gets played. So slowly it's. So the next chord, you do the same pattern, you just slide it down with your index finger on the fifth fret. So slowly it'll go like this. Two. Barring, I do two different fingers so I can keep the open strings open onto the 10th fret. And again, it's the same picking pattern. On the 10th fret, on the 5th and 4th strings, again with the 3rd and 2nd open, and it's the same picking pattern, but you only do this one, this chord twice, so it's... Down to the 9th fret, do the same thing, just once though. And then you do the 5 type chord on the 10th fret, and again, just once. And then to complete it, you go back to the first chord. Twice, and that completes the pattern. So it's an equal 4 parts through. So I'm going to play it one time through slowly, and then I'll play it one time through up to speed. So the whole pattern should go like this. So that's one rotation of it. So up to speed, it'd be more like this. The other thing that's very important in playing this riff is the palm muting. The only note that's not muted is the open second string, so it's... So you have to pay very close attention, and it's definitely a workout for the right arm, getting that part proper. Let's move on to the chorus. First off, we start with a five chord, which basically they all are. And again, with this tuning, I kind of let all the open strings ring. I like the dissonance that it creates, and that's the way I play it, and that's the way it is on the record. So we start at the 10th fret, with just basically, and do the first chug. So it's. And you keep that same picking pattern, and you move the same thing down to the second fret. So it's. Then to the 7th fret. Then to the 3rd fret. So it's kind of a downstroke, then an upstroke. So this is how it should sound when it's put all together. And the only other thing to know is the last time around, when it goes to the 3rd fret, you move it up to the 5th fret, so it's. And that chord holds over, but if you're playing it yourself, you would kick to a clean part and go back into that part. And the only other part is it builds up before the bridge, so it's doing the same chords, but instead of doing the chugga-chugga-chuggas, it's going. Here's one time through of what the chorus will sound like. There's a little octave part that goes over the chorus, again, just kind of to make it a little bit more interesting. So we're starting on the 9th fret on the 4th string and the 11th fret on the 2nd string. That would make the octave. You mute out the string in between. So slide that to the 5th fret. 7th fret, slide to the 4th fret. Hold it on the 5th fret. And then the walk up would be 2nd fret. 4th fret. So, very easy, it's like this. The bridge, 2 chords. It's all we need to know. It's a 5 chord starting at the 7th fret. To barred at the 10th fret on the 6th string. So it's just. You'll notice, layered in over the intro to the song and the beginning part of the bridge are some harmonics. So let's learn how those go. The first one starts at the 7th fret on the 2nd string. And then it goes to the 5th fret on the 1st string and the 2nd string. To 3rd string, 7th fret. Basically, you just move it down a string. And so 5th fret on the 2nd and 3rd string. So then you hit that same harmonic again, which is the 5th fret on the 3rd string, to 4th fret on the 4th string, 7th fret on the 2nd, to back to the one you started on, 5th fret on the 3rd, to, which is 7th fret, 2, 3, 2. So the whole piece together should sound like this, slowly. So one thing that I know for sure about this song is that if we ever start it too fast live, I can barely keep up with it. I mean, that the right hand in that verse is definitely a pretty good exercise to, you know, work on your picking and string skipping. It can definitely be a beast. I'll be looking back at the drummer sometimes like, slow it down. I can't keep up. So good luck with that one. Practice it. And I think it's cool. This song shows, you know, how a lot of the different layers work, because there's kind of a lot of things going on in it. So it'll be good to practice along and learn all the different parts.